Sorry, need you a drink. My throat's going.
Yeah. No, I've been laughing too much.
Talking all day.
Yeah, I've been talking in a loud room all day for 2 days.
I like Mob Moth's picture because it looks like he's like, damn.
Yeah.
Whose picture?
The non-human.
Monas.
Monas? Yeah.
Commander Mona.
The fact that he's like...
It sounded like you called him Mon Mothma.
I did, because I don't know what Mon Mothma looks like.
Well, first of all, she's an old human woman, so...
Yeah.
That doesn't fit either of those two.
I do apologize.
Mon Mothma was the lady who was doing the briefing for the second Death Star.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I got it.
Many Moth and spies die to give us this blah, blah, blah.
Not enough.
Not enough.
I see what boffins look like.
Well, and the thing about boffins, though, their entire race is pretty much built on spying on everybody else.
And fucking everybody over, yeah.
Like, they give information to everybody.
They're fucking the people over they're paid to.
Yeah, so, I mean, like, really, the boffins are, like, it's kind of like, several Bothans died for this. Also, several Bothans stole your information while you were while you hired them. So, I mean, it's kind of half of one, half of the other.
They generally keep to their contracts. If you're paying them, they're not going to steal your information.
You know who else died because of this? True hero, Dash Rendar.
Right, that's enough silence. So,
he didn't die, he's just hiding.
Right. You're led into the command room. In there is Mon Mothma and Janda Dano and a few other, like, Imperial? Rebel
bigwigs. Oh my god, they already betrayed us to the rebels and the Imperials!
Darth Vader's here!
You're sort of hanging out.
Hello there, young apprentices.
Darth Vader,
congratulations! We have co-opted the rebellion into the Empire.
Am I the only one who wants to see the movies remade with Darth Vader's voice being like that?
Yes.
Darth Vader walks in, holding a cup of coffee. Just went on a sip of coffee and hello.
Okay, so great.
Yeah.
Congratulations! A winner is you,
guys.
So, this won't stand. What, you've brought the thing here? A Sith artifact here with a rebellion?
I thought you wanted us to get...
No. See, she's upset that we brought it here directly instead of, like, bounced it around as normal.
Alright, just...
But we have a good reason.
Good reason.
We have good intelligence at the Death Star... was already on its way here.
Problem one, we had a bit of a spy problem.
Taken care of.
Here's a hollow trade of the occurrence. Don't mind the audio.
The Sith architect. More of the first thing.
Archaeologist.
More of the first thing was true than the second. He was actually a Sith. Archaeologist.
It was, you know, truer than you might expect.
So, we had a spy on his base. Someone you brought in, if I remember correctly.
We were sent to acquire. We didn't bring them into the organization.
We cannot use this weapon. It's a Sith. You know, it's designed by evil. It will do only nothing but evil. At this point, you know, Commander Mona will step in this, but Mon Mothma, we must. You know, this is our only way of destroying the Death Star. And they're going to start getting into a bit of an argument over this.
I mean, it's not like there's some conveniently placed exhaust port that a starfighter could fire a thing in that would take the plasma torpedo directly to the core and cause it to explode. That would be ridiculous. Who would design that kind of thing?
Only an idiot would design something like that. But we gotta stop Mommy and Daddy from arguing.
Real quick. While they're arguing, can I use contraption to... Real quick, on the recording thing I have, since Calculon was there at the interrogation, so that he can splice in the part where our Sith prisoner has explained that the Death Star is on its way here, and he's going to turn up the volume loud enough to drown out Mama and Dada.
Oh my god, yes.
Alright,
did I just hear a facepalm? Who facepalmed?
I didn't even hear all of that, but I'll facepalm with you.
It was... Yeah. Oh, no,
we're nearly out of light side points.
Yeah,
we only need one for the final Hadouken.
We only need one.
So, what's the difficulty on that, Gray? I mean, for contraption, it's going to be a hard check anyway.
Yeah, make it hard. I'm going to spend one to upgrade.
Oh. See, we now have one back. Ah, goddammit. It gets louder.
They just start yelling louder.
Yeah.
It was a good idea, but meh.
So this point is right, just gonna...
Shall I charm their pants firmly onto their... Let's say firmly
what?
On... So, charm their pants off doesn't sound good. We just want to charm their pants firmly in place. Also, why is the planet's eyes shifting?
What? Gavin has a lazy. Gavin has a lazy eye. Don't judge.
No. Okay. Shall I make a charm check to get their attention to make them stop arguing at least, or what else? Or what sort of check would you think that would be?
Blow. A negotiate check, probably.
Negotiation. All right. Slide whistle. Boop. All right. What would be the difficulty?
Hard, and I'm gonna upgrade once.
I can aid with negotiation. I have
look, three chips.
Okay, do you have more than three?
No, I have exactly three. I also have smooth talk or negotiation.
What does that one do?
I
think that one gets rid of black dice.
I can spend triumphs to gain additional success.
How about we go through you, since I don't actually have anything like that. We go through you, but I assist you.
Sure.
I'm not sure how good that's going to be.
Great. How many bonus dice do I get for my kickin' duds?
Okay, so you have three yellows and... Okay, three yellows.
Yellows and a green.
Actually, no, I don't give you any more than that. Wait, do you have a presence of four?
No, I have a presence of three.
Okay, then yeah, it's just three yellows.
Okay. Oh, wait, I can stim you.
Oh, I can give you drugs. No, you can't.
Okay, I'm going to say Adam's hands are just shaking.
He drugged himself too much.
No, all right, no,
and it's
no.
Going to be a hard check with one upgrade. So
you're out of actual you're out of the injectables. You're down to suppositories.
Bonus dice of any color as long as it's black.
Oh. Yeah. Great. So, seriously, how many bonus dice do I get from my wonderful robe and my hover chair?
I'm
sure this
back.
Gives me an for my inspiring noticed. Presence.
Why do you have an extra green die?
From you, your presence.
No, my presence is only three.
Oh, so I don't. Get anything
we can spend a light side point in order to get that, though.
Yeah. So wait. So you don't get it. So I don't get anything from you.
You can get a blue, yeah.
Okay, and I'll light that, I guess.
But yeah, no, I'm actually not an amazing negotiator. I'm a decent negotiator.
Yeah. So great, does that look good?
For making us look good than making other people listen to us.
Pretty much.
You basically doctored the reports.
That looks about right. Gray, is that right?
Yeah, that's right.
Okay.
Okay, well, dice, please don't.
Please, dice.
Yes!
Yes.
Yep, you'll get...
Mommy, Daddy, please stop fighting.
They'll stop arguing.
They're going to still argue.
They are united in their rejection of our plan.
Yeah.
No, they're not united. Well, Danada and Mothma are, but Mona and... keep getting his name, Rihal, are for the plan, because they're the guys who sent you in.
Yeah, look, guys... As the ranking Sith warlord here, I can fully assure you that this device will only be used for the benefit of the rebellion, and that once the Death Star is destroyed, I mean, you guys could do whatever you want with it, and if you need an accountant to help you deal with, you know, the various accounting things of breaking it down, well, I'm available. My job in the Empire is going to probably be terminated after this.
Einrich takes this moment to go into a corner and whimper because he just used some terrible, terrible phrasing for that.
I have a membership card and everything. You want to see? My credentials are legit.
It was very easy to do. Just have to go over to this known Sith homeworld and, you know,
take a bunch of tests. And...
What's that one thing where one person face palms, another person face palms, and everyone face palms?
It's like, I mean, and then just like as he's holding out his hand to show them the card, they're like, "What's that symbol on your hand?" Oh, this is the symbol that got burned into my hand when we took a bunch of Sith tests to get access to the super weapon.
Also, we have two on one person's butt.
No, it was on his tongue.
Yeah,
and it's only one.
Oh my goodness, guys. Just,
I'm sorry, I wish I had a better filter, but I don't, and I have to do
it's
this.
It's great, but it's oh my god, guys.
I know.
It's okay, you've set yourself on this path a long time ago, I'm ready for this. So, at this point, Momoth is going to go, guards, seize them.
Oh.
We'll be so blatant that they will take us at face value and actually let us do this.
No, she's just having us being arrested.
Except none of the guards move.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
And they go, guards. And Mary goes, I'm sorry, Mon Mothma. You are no longer in charge of this rebellion. You do not have the...
Vision or authority?
Scruples? Yeah. Not scruples. Word.
You have too many scruples for war.
You have too many scruples and not enough will to carry this forth. You know,
congratulations, guys! We just led a coup.
Yep, we're now in charge of the rebellion. And Mon Mothma is going to be speechless for a second. But you are generals and spies. Who do you have to lead the political side? At which point, the door behind you will hiss open.
Not Jar Jar.
Yes.
This is the point where all my plans come together.
Oh no!
Oh my god! Damn it, Gray.
Well, in theory, this would be the one way that Jar Jar could redeem himself for actually causing this whole fucking mess.
I mean, this isn't Jar Jar. This is the other guy.
No, this is Jar Jar.
This is Jar Jar.
After we messed with him.
We got so many triumphs on
the disguise check or something like that that we essentially changed his form to something of like the big boss.
Basically, he went into metamorphosis and went from the skinny version to the big fat version. Didn't grow the eye back though.
Eyes a big boss now.
Have we entered Jar Jar, you're a genius territory?
No, because
he hasn't done anything. We're the ones who
yeah,
did all
fair
this
enough,
for
fair
him.
Enough.
We have done horrible things, and this is the one thing I regret.
I love this.
I wasn't even there for this.
Gray.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Oh, the moment you did this, this was put into place. So, they've given me Jar Jar. Who could lead?
Oh my god.
The moment I had the idea for the coup, it's like, who could lead the. Oh, hello, Jar Jar.
Hello, Jar Jar. Oh, Jar Jar, you poor bastard.
Yes. So, at this point, everyone in the room is probably speechless, apart from Jar Jar.
And this is the best.
Who's going to be booming in his deep, much deeper voice? Launching into a prepared speech, which she's forgotten half of.
Oh no, I thought Jar Jar was competent.
But he's pretty good at improvising.
Yeah, so. He's improvising a speech that, you know, he was part of the Clone Wars, he fought in the Clone Wars. You know, his entire life has been spent fighting, you know, and he's now ready to lead.
Just think of a Rastafari and Brian Blessed.
Oh my god.
Okay, you know, I would actually enjoy that.
Yes,
I'm sorry. I can't do Brian Blessed.
No one can do Brian Blessed.
I'm kind of hard.
Gray, you've broken me.
Excellent. You did not see this one coming.
I was not expecting Jarier to come back, no!
I think I've actually wrapped all the way back around to being completely sane.
I think I've kind of gone that way too, because I'm not bawling out laughing, but yeah, I'm also not right.
For some reason, I actually support this.
I am behind this. Sienna's just going to have his chair hover over next to Jar Jar and nod decisively alongside him.
But you know what? Like Calibab comes back and goes like, "I'm coming with you guys. This is no more sane." Or is Calibab out like throwing up, like flipping over ad-ads or something?
Yeah, probably. So
at this point, the guards will start actually working. Working is not the right word. Doing something, and they will arrest Mon Mothma and John Dodonna.
Oh, Dodonna's not going to join us?
No, unfortunately not.
We could use those three dreadnoughts of his.
They may have active ways of taking them.
All right.
I'm not sure how well the coup's been planned.
Yeah. Well, we can roll for it later.
Okay, remember, you know what? We can plan it competently. They probably planned it more competently than we would have.
I cannot deny this.
Yeah. Your way would involve some sort of, like, giant vampire bats or something like that.
We could probably find some if we looked hard enough.
It is Star Wars, yeah.
Yeah.
So. This went well.
You know, we're actively making a rebellion that may have been maybe actually worse than
the Empire.
Yeah.
I don't think so. I mean, these guys do just want to stop the Empire, and they're willing to use force. They're willing to fight fire with fire, but, like, they're not actively evil and xenophobic and whatnot. Well, which is why we want to probably work with them to make sure that doesn't happen.
Okay, have you met us? We're going to accelerate this process.
We're going to lead the revolution! Yes, I am Stalin.
Oh no. Wow, that sure was an accent you just attempted.
Yeah,
apparently.
I don't even bother trying with an accent, really. So don't take it for anything.
Hey, non accents are fun.
Yeah. But yeah, no, I'm sure we're going to do very well. And this is all going to turn out perfectly, and the rebellion will be a success. So So Mona, good job there.
Mona, it's been. I would say it's been great, but I don't know you that well, so it's been. No, not even fun. Goodbye.
Oh! Double selfie with a Mothma and Dodonna being led away, of course. Obviously.
Yep.
So.
I know this is short, but I'm almost tempted to end the session here because, like, oh my god.
Yeah, that actually might be a good point, and give us a bit more time for.
Okay, yeah.
Best part, I just gotta say this, at the end of the next session, when we actually finished it, we got to do a tally sheet of what we did.
Not only what we did, but how we fucked up the Star Wars timeline. Because there's gonna be a lot of ticks to that.
Or we created our characters.
No, this is what we need to do. Chain is a tick where all we is a tick where all the places where we actually stopped going onto the track of being good guys and kept going on the track we are currently on now.
So Naboo is a big one.
All right. Okay.
I say running away from the Death Star was the first one.
No, I understand this. We're not bad guys. We're just a different kind of good.
No, we're pretty much bad guys.
Look, we are the hero that they need, not the one they deserve.
I've just got
thank
one.
You for,
thank I'm you just for trying to save an image which I think perfectly encapsulates the situation. But it's okay. Just fight.
Oh boy.
This ain't no place for no hero.
I've been
this
playing
ain't no Mortal. Place for
Ooh,
no
that is
better
massive.
Man. And that's all I'm going to sing because I don't want to get ID'd by YouTube.
I don't think it'll get that, but okay.
Yeah, I actually, like, the music video, as in it was a still frame, but that actually got taken down off of YouTube.
Yeah. Wait, this is hurt them being walked away?
Yeah, their expressions are pretty much perfect.
Okay. I have to say this, is that it's probably not going to be nearly as xenophobic, because think of the fact that the majority of the people who are taking over are, quote, Xenos.
Well, yeah. No, they're reverse xenophobic. They don't like humans.
Yeah.
Well, what's it? Mona's a human. Or is that the other one? Whatever. No, Baldi's a human.
Baldi.
Alright.
So I can't help but notice that Jen is looking a lot younger.
Hey, Jim, what can you do?
Well, so where the hell was this pick in the films?
I don't know. I think this is actually Death Star, so that's not actually Jen Dodonna. That's some other guy.
Yeah. Well,
the expression looks pretty good. There's enough of... Oh, goddammit, cat.
Goddammit, cat.
He just stuck his head up my trouser leg. I wasn't ready for that. I didn't even know he was there.
That's horrible.
Oh, whiskers up the trouser leg. Not really expecting that.
That doesn't sound pleasant.
Oh, that's awkward.
Okay.
Right, so.
Yeah, this is like Death Star, so this is actually like episode 3. But, yeah, it pretty much gives you an idea what the situation's
wow,
like.
Wow, if that's episode 3, she has not changed a day.
Oh, 6. Episode 6. Anyway, I'd say that's probably a good place to end for this week. Gives us a good long run at the Death Star next time.
Yeah. A trench run, you might say.
Except by trench run, you mean just blasting it over and over again with a giant death laser while we try to avoid its own death laser.
Yeah. Our smaller size will actually probably help us in that case.
Oh, yeah, actually.
Yeah, I doubt they can actually directly
attack Oh my god, Gray, you're going to have to stat up the Death Star.
Have fun with that one.
You're fine with the ass until...
I'm going to completely fudge it.
Okay. Because I actually figure that our death beam will not necessarily blow up the Death Star with one shot. It's just like an ultra powerful turbo laser beam thing.
Yeah. Don't give him ideas. It might have been a one shot kill.
Presumably we'll have to like disable defenses or something.
Yeah, it's not gonna be just one dice roll. I've got a few plans, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, it is designed to repel an assault of this scale.
So what you're saying is that its shields can, in fact, handle firepower of this magnitude?
Yep.
Oh, okay.
Well actually, that is the thing, because wasn't it mentioned in, like, the first movie or something like... Well, the first of the original trilogy, that,
designed to...
Capital ships actually can't really touch it. It's the fighters that can fly past the shield.
Yeah.
Well, actually, I don't think it even has shields. I think it's just the point defense.
It's just,
it would be really stupid not to give it a shield.
Well, they have to use a ground-based one for the second.
But
I think the other thing, though, is that, like, the Death Star is just literally studded with thousands and thousands of turbo lasers, which are, like, the capital ship killer.
Also, like, because think of it, the Death Star is not a ship. It's a space station. It is a mobile space station the size of a moon, so... It's gonna have lots of guns.
Okay, yeah, apparently it does have shields. Oh, wait, no, that's to disable all the functions.
Anyway.
Okay, yeah, it does have small gaps, actually, in the shields.
That's why they're probably flying the small ships.
The Empire believed that this was harmless since only small ships could wiggle through the gaps.
Yeah, because remember, like, we're talking about Star Wars, so if you can end the recording at any time,
yeah,
I think.
So
it then goes on to mention that the shields of the second Death Star would have had no such gaps.
Goodbye, everybody. It's
It's
a brave new world where Jar Jar is going to be president.
This is all your fault, and that's all going
to
end the recording.
You can follow CN on Facebook, and Twitter, and don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and...
Oh my god.
Although, if you could like, comment, and subscribe, that'd be great.
An organization!
Congratulations!
That's an obligation, that's not a duty.
We didn't, like, the organization didn't get overthrown, it's
we
just
had a reshuffling of management, come on!
Yeah, it's a new hat. I mean, we would probably get a more, like,
CN is in favor of new hats.
We would get more duty merely because we just did a major resource acquisition for the organization.
I'm almost afraid because, like, I almost feel like political support should be taken away, but also added.
It stays the same, basically.
Yeah, what we accidentally did.
Yeah, I'll give you an extra free in political support because you have more political support. It just wasn't. It's not the same political body that you were at the start of the episode.
Well, no, it is. It's just a different faction.
Yeah, it's a different faction in control, and this faction likes you more.
Basically, we went from Democrats to Republicans.
Well, yeah, we just elected the space equivalent of J.H.W. Bush.
James W. Bush?
I started recording as well, by the way.
Good. Thank you. Save us from ourselves, Gray.
Okay, so, you got 3 duty. XP, only 5 this week, I think.
We spent the majority of that just getting, like, non-antidotal evidence from the,
Yeah.
Oh.
It's fine.
I have to say, if Cian does become a Sith Lord in between games, like in reshuffles his character to be a Force sensitive, we know where we would have a apprentice.
Oh,
a broken Sith Inquisitor.
I'm actually going to end the recording properly this time. So
yeah, see everyone next week. Have a good one.
Bye,
everybody.
See ya.